Today is October 23rd. It's the 297th day of the year, and this is the On This Day podcast. Born on this day, a handful of interesting folks from the worlds of sports and entertainment. Born on this day in 1935, American professional golfer Chichi Rodriguez. Rodriguez is born in Rio Piedras, Puerto Rico. When he is 7, he gets a job as a caddy at a golf course to help earn money for his family. He teaches himself how to play golf using a guava tree branch as a club and a tin can as a golf ball, mimicking the motions of the golfers he caddies for. Before he is a teenager, he's scoring in the mid-60s. He turns pro in 1960, wins the Denver Open in 1963, and goes on to win 7 more PGA titles over the next decade and a half, 8 titles in all. In 1992, Chichi Rodriguez is inducted into the World Golf Hall of Fame. Also born on this day in 1940, Brazilian football legend Pelé. Born Edson Arantes do Nascimento, pardon my Portuguese, and named after inventor Thomas Edison. He's given the nickname Pelé by his schoolmates. He doesn't know why, nor do his schoolmates, but it's a nickname, and it sticks. He starts playing professionally when he's 16, playing for Santos Football Club, and he wins his first World Cup playing for the Brazil national football team in 1958 when he's 17. 2 more FIFA World Cup wins follow in 1962 and 1970. Pelé goes on to become the top goal scorer of all time for Brazil, and according to his website, he is the all-time leading scorer in the history of the sport, scoring 1,283 goals in 1,366 matches, in league play, on tour, and in friendly matches. Pelé is hailed as the greatest player of all time of what he calls the beautiful game. Born on this day in 1942, best-selling author, TV producer, and film director Michael Crichton. He's born in Chicago, his father a journalist, and when Crichton is 14, he writes a travel column for the New York Times. Though he's passionate about writing, he studies medicine at Harvard. His time at Harvard Medical School is a time of discovery. Mainly, he discovers that he doesn't want to be a doctor. He receives his MD and then pursues a career as a novelist and filmmaker. He publishes a few medical thrillers while in medical school, published under a pseudonym, and one that he publishes under his own name, a book called The Andromeda Strain, which hits the New York Times bestseller list, is adapted as a film a couple years later, and many years later as a TV series. He continues to churn out best-selling novels and makes his feature film debut as a director with the 1973 film Westworld. In the 1990s, he creates the TV series ER based on his medical school experiences. And around the same time, his novel Jurassic Park is adapted for the screen by Steven Spielberg. My personal favorite Michael Crichton book is Travels, an autobiographical journal of his many travels throughout the external world and into the internal world of his own mind. Michael Crichton, who passes away in 2008 at the age of 66, sells over 200 million copies of his books, wins an Emmy, a Peabody, and a Technical Achievement Oscar for his use of computer programs in 1973's Westworld, and he has a dinosaur named after him. And born on this day in 1959, film director and multi-hyphenate Sam Raimi. Raimi begins making films at an early age, making Super 8 epic short films with childhood friend Bruce Campbell. He goes to Michigan State for a year and a half, during which time he makes the horror short Within the Woods, and then the low-budget feature It's Murder. And this is before the time when everyone has a camera on their phone, or you can buy a 4K camera for a couple $1,000s. This is the time when you still had to go out with a camera, shoot celluloid, get it developed in a lab, and then cut it together. He drops out of college to make his next film, The Evil Dead, which he makes with future longtime collaborators Campbell, brothers Ted Raimi and Ivan Raimi. and editor Joel Coen of the Coen Brothers fame. The Evil Dead slowly becomes a huge hit and then a cult classic, spawning a series of Evil Dead sequels and establishing Sam Raimi as one of the most inventive directors in modern cinema. And finally, also born on this day in 1959, singer, songwriter, accordionist, and king of the parody song, Weird Al Yankovic. Born Alfred Yankovic in Downey, California, he starts playing the accordion when he's six. He'll give you a half dozen reasons why his parents choose the accordion for him, but whatever the truth is, they make the right choice. While studying architecture at Cal Poly, he begins recording his own songs, and then parody songs, inspired by the likes of Spike Jones, Stan Freberg, Frank Zappa, as well as Monty Python and Kentucky Fried Movie. He records a song in the bathroom across from the college radio station, his parody of My Sharona by The Knack, singing it as My Bologna. My Bologna makes its way onto the Dr. Demento show, and Dr. Demento encourages Yankovic, who follows up Bologna with Another One Rides the Bus, spoofing the Queen hit Another One Bites the Dust, and his take on Lola by The Kinks, which he reimagines as Yoda. Y-O-D-A Yoda. And the rest, unbelievably, is history. Weird Al still churns out albums of spot-on parodies and polka medleys. If you have the opportunity to see him live in concert, do it. Even if you don't like Weird Al, even if you can't stand him, I'm telling you, you're gonna have a great time. He puts on an incredible show with more costume changes than a quick change act. Weird Al, born on this day in 1959. There are 69 days left in the year. On This Day is produced by me, Dave Schultz. Thank you very much for listening. But it's all right now. In fact, it's a gas. But it's all right. Jumping jack flash. It's a gas, gas, gas. People try to put us down. Talking about my generation. Just because we get around. Talking about my generation. They really do look awful. Talking about